Here in the functional MRI room at the University of California, Berkeley, it's story time. All in all, getting a brain scan for this project isn't a bad gig. Just kick back, watch some videos, listen to some stories.
From PRX, this is the Moth Radio Hour.
So all the person has to do is lay there and listen to the stories and think about, you know, the stories as anyone would.
Okay, Mark, we're gonna start now. Are you ready?
Yep.
But obviously this is much more than a midday break.
Okay, great, thank you.
With support from the National Science Foundation, neuroscientist Jack Gallant and his team are using big data techniques to analyze these brain scans and map where in our heads we process language-related information.
So we can measure changes in blood flow throughout your entire brain simultaneously, about once a second. We have very large data sets, and we need to essentially drill down and mine into those data sets to recover the important functional information.
How's it gonna grow a flower?
This visualization shows brain activity patterns that play out as a person listens to a story.
So on the right here is sort of a karaoke view of a story that people are listening to.
He made holes with the dibber and set the bulbs inside, and he was careful when he patted down the dirt so they wouldn't turn.
Colors show parts of the brain that are active at each point in the story.
Red tends to be parts of the stories that's representing meaning in the stories that is social. Green tends to be the material properties of objects and the structure of the world. So you can see now we're switching, and you see that the patterns of activity become much more green.
They estimate there are 200 to 400 modules spread all around the brain where functional thought occurs. 100 to 150 of those are linked to language processing. Red here shows the areas of more brain activity, blue areas of less.
So on the right here, we have some movies that subjects were shown in the magnet.
They're also using the fMRI data to build a mathematical model, or decoder, that accurately predicts how the brain extracts meaning from silent movies.
Here's an ocean scene. You can see it gets fish. Okay, it thinks there's a flower. That's not perfect, but you can see it gets water, swimming, ocean floor.
Gallant says practical applications could one day include new therapies to help stroke patients recover language skills, faster, more nimble computers, even brain-machine interfaces that would allow communication without speech.
In order to, you know, heal people that have diseases or broken brains, or to apply the knowledge we get from neuroscience to, say, build better computers, we need to really understand the brain at a fundamental level.
That's not a job they take lying down. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.